This is a poetry reading in honor of your mother in celebration of her life and to encourage you during this transition. This one is entitled, She Still Has a Blessing. Although Mommy has gone away, she still has a blessing to give each day. It's in the memory of her smile, let it warm your soul. It's in the memory of her kind words, let it lift you always. It's in the memory of her hugs, may it bring you comfort. Although Mommy has gone away, you can still receive her blessing throughout your lifelong days. It's in the love of God she gave, if you cultivate this same love in your heart and share it with others. It's the wise words she spoke in her, if in her absence you still hear it and obey. It's in the first commandment with a promise, if even in her death you honor her in your living. One is entitled, Know That. Know that the sweet aroma that once fragranced your home is now incense at God's throne. Know that the heart that once captivated you now hollows you to contain more of Him. Know that death does not define your loved one's end when the life they live is planted in others. Know that the love that your departed one gave from God transcends time and space when you continue to share its gift. Know that although your loved one has left this dimension, she tugs at the heart of God for you and yours in the heavenly realm. Know that the request your departed one made to Him for you in their passing, God has already fulfilled from eternity past. Okay, and this one poem is called A Mother's Love. A mother's love makes God's heart visible, makes God's love tangible, makes God's plans conceivable, makes God's voice audible. A mother's love makes God's mercy conveyable. And this is entitled As Long As I Can Remember. And this was the poems I shared with you where I had prepared them for someone who's had a family member that passed. And this was prepared for a woman who lived to be 104 years old. This was on her 101st birthday. And the daughter had asked me to prepare a poem that she could share that day. It goes like this, as long as I can remember. For as long as I can remember, you have always been there encouraging me. And there's no time I can recall that I did not find you believing in me. And I do not believe there has been a moment that I could not count on you to direct me and respect me, to guide me, to abide with me, to laugh with me, and feel for me too. You have brought me great memories to balance tough times. You've deposited goodness when the world was unkind. And to know I could count on you when everything around me was changing brought me such peace like a river flowing. Knowing you strengthens my faith and reassures me there is a God, and I know where He lives. He lives in you. And I sincerely thank you for being the place where God lives so that I could see Him on earth up really close when I look at you. And this particular poem is called There Was a Tree. And it's another poem that I wrote for a daughter, a woman who called me to write a poem for her mother who was turning 70. And it's I'm using the metaphor of a tree entitled There Was a Tree. There was a tree that did not break. And when the wind blew hard, it did not fall. And the tree could brace itself in a hurricane. It could withstand the weight of the snow and the ice. And in the hottest of days, it was still cool. The tree did not resist the seasons. It yielded willingly to life's changes. And always remaining true, the leaf never withered and always yielded the choices of fruit on time in God's time. The tree knew its maker, and we knew the tree as you. It is your branches we have set under to cool ourselves. It's your fruit we have tasted to gain nourishment, to sustain our strength, and to simply enjoy. It's the roots, your roots that have given us sustenance and stamina and connectedness to life's truth. It's your seed that has sprouted faith, hope, and love in our hearts. The sweetness of your sap and its aroma has made our lives pleasantly fragrant. Thank you for being the tree that has shielded us from the blight of the sun while allowing enough rays through to encourage our growth. Thank you for allowing us a refuge from the storm's torrent while allowing its mist to cleanse us and refresh us. Thank you for allowing the stripping away of your bark to be recycled into wisdom, life's fuel for the ages. Thank you for remaining planted in the Word of God, that our lives could be enriched by the flow of God's love through you. We know a tree who knows his maker. We know the tree as you. This is for your mom. No one knows how a rose grows. Indelible is the fragrance it sows. It's people that bring a definition to the heavenly scent, like your mom, whose spirit fragrance was a rose of Sharon filled with love, heart testament. And the scent from flowers in a vase cannot compare to the beauty and the fragrance of a life lived out by faith and grace, like your mom.